Close your eyes and imagine. The ground is covered in green moss with a sprinkling of blue. Here and there a few flowers grow. There, in a small corner, between two golden yellow flowers, if you look very carefully, you can see a teeny tiny flower. What a small flower! The petals are pink and green. It's a very rare type. On this spot, the tiny fairy Syrielle often rests. Come, sit comfortably here, and I'll tell you her tale. Large trees surround and protect this small paradise where our story begins. Their branches are so heavy that you can't believe they stay attached. And the foliage is so thick and dense that an elephant could hide there. Really. They are secret trees. And in the trunk of these trees, one ice-cold winter's night, Syrielle was born. Syrielle is a very funny fairy. Do you know why? Every time she bursts out laughing, a sweet tune comes out of her mouth. Listen. The fairy Syrielle did not always have reason to laugh. On the contrary, she was rather unfortunate. Although she had the sweetest laugh, she was largely ignored by all the other fairies and gnomes. She often had to play alone, and this made her very sad. One day, when she was again alone, she went and lay on a piece of blue moss and gazed up at the stars. No one wants to be with me. I'm a worthless fairy. And she lay there for a long time, crying. After a few hours, she dried her eyes, and she had an idea, a wonderful idea. She decided that she would travel to where the sky ended, and there she could find a star. Then I would have done something that no one has ever done before, and then everyone will want to laugh and play with me. She raced to the secret tree where she lived, and packed her things and flew away to where the sky ended. The journey was long, long, very long. So long that Syrielle began to feel hungry. She stopped by a sparkling river with blue vanilla flowers all along the banks. Her favorite food. She sat next to one of the flowers and began eating the petals. Not too far from there, though, was an ogre, watching Syrielle very closely. She looks very pretty, he said to himself. I would like to make her my girlfriend, because no one here wants anything to do with me. But the ogre was not so attractive to look at. His ears were hairy, dirty. His nose was covered in green pimples, and his teeth were black and yellow. Above all, he was also very, very, very big, and everyone was afraid of him. Syrielle looked up, and when she saw this dreadful-looking creature, she hid behind the first petal she saw. No, silly, not in there, called the ogre. The fairy had hidden in the petals of Spikeface, the most dangerous flower in the whole land.
Ow! Ow! Ah!
Shrieked Syrielle, and she escaped to the nearest tree. The ogre went over to her and promised her that he knew the only antidote to tend to her burns. They had only to find the berry of 100 flavors, which grew a few kilometers away. Then the giant ogre set the tiny fairy on the enormous tuft of hair that sprouted from his shoulder, and they went searching for the berry of 100 flavors. By the way, my name is Auguste, said the ogre.
I am Syrielle, sighed the fairy before she fell asleep.
Syrielle was exhausted. She sighed now and then in her sleep because her wounds were causing her a great deal of pain. Auguste stroked her carefully with his little finger to calm her. We'll get there in time, little star. Trust me.
Auguste was very happy that he was able to help the poor fairy. He had also had a very lonely life. He lived in a very strange place, a sort of cave, where his only companions were quiet spiders. It was always cold there, because daylight could not reach the cave. At night you could hear the sounds of insects and the hiss of snakes. Moreover, maggots had gnawed through the walls and left behind a trail of sticky slime, which would drip onto the hair of the ogre while he slept. Ugh! Revolting, isn't it? Our two friends continued their way towards the horizon and saw a dark and sinister-looking forest before them.
What is that?
Asked the frightened Syrielle. That is the mysterious forest, answered Auguste in a just as unsure tone. We must go through, I'm afraid, in order to find the berries that will make you better. It was extremely cold, and so dark was it under the trees that the two friends could hardly see their own feet in front of them. Sometimes they heard strange sounds, or the howls and cries of the wild animals. Suddenly the ogre stopped.
He couldn't go any further because someone or something held both his feet and his legs tight. Oh no! Two-headed snakes! Help, Syrielle! Help me! The fairy is very weak because her wounds are getting worse. She summons up her remaining strength and flies around the snakes, which try to bite her. She zigzags in and around them at amazing speed. She flies so fast that the snakes not only cannot catch her, but they get completely tangled up together in a huge knot. After they recover from their fright, Auguste and Syrielle stare at each other and burst into laughter.
Listen! Listen! Don't you recognize this melodious laugh? Yes, it is Syrielle. The sweet laugh before she falls back to sleep.
They come out of the forest and arrive at the field of the perfumed gnomes. Here grow all sorts of different flowers, trees and berries.
Look, Syrielle, wake up, we're here.
Auguste found the berry of 100 flavors, and the fairy ate it all up in one bite. Immediately, her wounds healed and she started to laugh and laugh and laugh while flying above Auguste, who had to laugh as well. Syrielle sat quietly on some brushwood and thought, and said to herself,
"Auguste saved my life. This is indeed a true friend."
She flew up into the air, straight to the ogre, and sat right on the tip of his nose.
"Thank you," she cried to him, and then gave him a big kiss, right on his nose.
Auguste was completely moved.
No one had ever given him a kiss before, and definitely not such a tiny fairy.
They remained quiet and promised each other that they would always be there for each other. Then they set off back to where Syrielle lived.
Suddenly Auguste turned to Syrielle and asked, "Actually, tiny fairy, where were you going before I met you?"
Our fairy smiled and calmly answered, "Oh, nowhere important. I'm quite happy to go home now." And to herself she said, from the bottom of her heart, "I found him, my star." Real friendship can overcome the greatest differences. Friendship is a precious star which is more valuable than
all the wealth in the world.